Welcome back to the Carolina Sea Hornets. Today you're going to see the clearest dive I've ever had in North Carolina. Once again, we are at the Normania shipwreck. This will probably be the last time we dive this wreck for the rest of the year. Between the tourists and other spear fishermen who constantly fish this place out, there isn't much left to do here. So in the future, you'll be seeing us checking out other locations. I'll be doing some further narrating throughout this video, so enjoy.
Thank you.
about this time, Joe and I have both caught our first lobsters, and he has his sights set on a grouper. He shoots this grouper and stones it, but as he's about to finish it off, it comes back to life and hides in the wreckage. In this video, there's going to be a second dive where we simply just came back down on this site to try and retrieve that grouper, and he did manage to get that grouper, as you'll see later on in this video. So this is the first time I've seen African pompano myself. Unfortunately, I didn't get to shoot these. I really should have held onto my scooter and used it to get closer, but I was thinking that the scooter would scare them away, so I dropped it. I tried to swim close enough, but I had the wrong gun with me for this dive, and I couldn't quite get far enough to get to them. Thank you. So right here, my friend Joe has actually found an anchor that was off into the distance of this wreckage. This man can find anything under the water. Here we are on our second dive for Joe to retrieve the injured grouper, and I wanted to test out this Aquatic Hunt container and spear for lionfish. The container itself is pretty nice, and it feels easier than the zookeeper to use all around. I like the built-in spear holder and the various attachment points to suit just about anybody. Now, I must say, this will be one of the most frustrating dives I've had in a while, and it may be just as frustrating for you to watch. The two-piece purple spear they sell, in my opinion, is a waste and needs several design changes. You'll see me missing a lot of lionfish due to the spear slipping in my hand, bending, and on the first use, the strap breaks, so I end up having to tie it to itself to get some use out of it. The strap itself is a weaker strap, too. I've voiced these concerns to the folks that make this product, so hopefully they'll release a much more improved version in the future. They also stated they had another model called the Tourney King, which already addresses some of these issues, but it's a quite a bit longer than I'd like. So until then, I'll stick to my hammerhead spear.
Thank you.
While we were up top, I tried bottom fishing for some grouper. I felt like I got a grouper hit and my line was stuck on some kind of structure and was not coming up. So here is Joe tangled up in my 50-pound braid fishing line, and it looked like it was only going to get worse. So I went ahead and cut my line to help him as much as I could. He said there was another grouper in there as well, so I imagine either the one he had or that one is what got my line. At this part, I accidentally dropped my spear gun as I was trying to clip it off of my belt. Then, all of a sudden, sharks start to take an interest in me. I have my shark shield on, and I've been using it for 2 years now. This is the closest any shark has gotten to me while it was on. Now, I treat sharks the same as I would as any predator my size if it's facing me. I'm facing it, trying to read its body language, and not back down. I'm hearing Joe screaming shark above me. Then a second shark appears, and I'm starting to think they are very attracted to these dying lionfish. Eventually, they back off enough for me to get off the ground and start my decompression, and they don't do any harm. That's it for today's adventures. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe if you want to see more of my dives on the Carolina Sea Hornets.